Board exams are right around the corner, and the pressure seems to be rising for both children and their parents. Here are 6 tips that can help you to keep your stress levels under control as the exam season approaches. While some amount of stress is normal and expected and can actually help you perform better, too much of it can lead to distress. Remember that your child will emulate you no matter how old they get. So it's important for you to keep your own stress levels under control. A child responds well to a calm and reassuring adult. Reduce uncertainty. When we don't know what to expect, it can make us feel really anxious. So it's a good idea to visit the exam center at least a couple of days before the exam. Once your child knows the route, where to go, what to do, they will feel more confident and more reassured on the day of the exam. The same goes for preparation right before the exam. So making sure that their admit card is in place, everything that they need is already packed for them, can really help them to perform better. It's important to encourage your child to step out of the house for at least a couple of hours every day. While children might have a tendency to stay locked up indoors and just study all the time, that can actually be counterproductive and increase their stress levels. When your child steps out to play, meet friends, maybe go for a dance class, go for a yoga class, it actually helps to release happy hormones, endorphins and oxytocin, and that can help them perform better by lowering their stress levels. What to do on the day of the exam? Discourage caffeine. Children have a tendency to come and write the exam on an empty stomach after just consuming coffee or tea. This can be quite counterproductive because caffeine mimics the effects of anxiety on the body. So instead of consuming caffeine, have something like coconut water, maybe orange juice or a piece of apple. This will not only help wake you up, but also nourish you and help you feel less stressed out. Once you enter the exam hall, take a moment to just look around, make yourself feel familiar to the space, then close your eyes and practice audible sighing. This is how it looks. You breathe in through the nose, exhale from your mouth. 5 to 7 of these breaths can help induce the relaxation response and help you focus better in the exam. What to do right after the exam? Your child will be hungry and sleepy right after writing the exam. This is because an exam is a triggering event. It activates the sympathetic nervous system of the body that is responsible for fight or flight. After the exam is over, the parasympathetic nervous system, the relaxing part of the body, kicks in. And so it's natural to feel sleepy, it's natural to feel hungry. So ensure that your ward gets a couple of hours of sleep or rest before they start preparing again. This will help prevent burnout and help reduce the pressure. I highly recommend practicing a body scan meditation or yoga nidra after your exam is over. Lastly, let us remember to be there for our children and to support them through this challenging time. Yes, board exams are important, but they're not the make or break all of your child's career. Your child will be just fine. I hope this helps.